The Amarillo Hispanic Chamber of Commerce has been around since 1986. Its mission is to improve the lives and community by focusing on Hispanic and minority-owned businesses. And the organization has an amazing leader. As we celebrate women's suffrage this week, KMR Local 4's Jackie Kingston sits down with the executive director.
We are celebrating 100 years of women having the right to vote, and we're honoring some amazing women in our community. Ruby Moreno is the executive director of the Amarillo Hispanic Chamber of Commerce. She's a graduate of West Texas A&M University. Just 3 years ago, she went from intern at the Hispanic Chamber to leading it just 1 month after graduation. Ruby joining me now in studio. Ruby, your career has obviously taken off. You obviously have a lot of potential, and you're doing really great things, so thanks for taking some time. I know you're busy. To talk with us.
Thank you. It's an honor to be here with you guys.
Talk to me about women's suffrage. What does 100 years of having the right to vote mean for you?
Yeah, well, suffrage means being able to voice your opinion, being able to tell people what you think. And I think you should be able to voice your opinions to have a seat at the table, you know, have a voice in your community.
Absolutely. Talk to me about a time, obviously, as the executive director of the Hispanic Chamber, the corporate world is not always so welcoming to women. Mm-hmm. Tell me about a time where you've had to fight for that place at the table.
Yeah, well, there's been many times, especially being a young Hispanic woman in the business world, it's been very tough. But at the same time, I don't think I've necessarily had to fight for a seat at the table. It has been very difficult, and I think from the times that I've served in the community, I've earned my seat there. Just basically showing my character, who I really am, and being a leader in the community. And a leader truly does have to always think about personal development and making sure you're growing.
What are some of the ways that you feel like you do that, and what are some of the ways that you would tell, you know, maybe your interns or other women in the community who are getting started in the world of business to continue to do that?
I would say surround yourself with leaders, and surround yourself with those individuals that inspire you to do better, to inspire you to volunteer, to get involved, to get engaged in the community. That's what really makes the difference.
I absolutely think that's true. I tell my students at WT all the time, dig in, you know, go volunteer, go, you know, be a part of the community there where you want to be. Mm-hmm. Talk to me about your career you know, how you kind of got to this place and where you hope to lead the Hispanic Chamber in the future.
Yeah, well, I was an intern at the Hispanic Chamber for a year and a half before I became executive director. When graduation was approaching, they offered me the executive director role, and I mean, I was honored, you know, and I've had the privilege to work with some amazing individuals at the Hispanic Chamber. They're smart, they are experienced, and they have taught me so much. I've had some great mentors, met some great small business owners, and I just want to have a voice in the community, to get our Hispanic community involved, to get them out there to vote, and to support local.
Ruby, tell me about some of the obstacles that you feel like you've had to overcome in your career, or that you feel like you've been able to guide the Hispanic Chamber through.
Yeah, well, there's been many obstacles that I've had to overcome, but one of the major obstacles that I've had to overcome is transitioning from an intern to executive director at the Hispanic Chamber. Like I mentioned, I was an intern for a year and a half, and that was a very difficult transition because I was intimidated being with these intelligent individuals who were experienced, and I was so young, fresh out of college. I was a little scared to voice my opinion and to be involved in those important decisions that can make or break a deal, you know. So that has been one of the most difficult obstacles.
How do you hope to inspire other women to engage in civic leadership and to dig into our community?
Well, I would say educating our youth. I think educating our youth is the most important thing to do. That will get them involved. You show them at a young age, and really focusing on getting them to stay dedicated to something and to stay committed. And at the Hispanic Chamber, we have an internship program through WT, and we allow our students to be engaged in these conversations, to be a part of the table. That way they feel involved, they know the process, and they will keep that going throughout the other students.
I feel like our community is so welcoming to those small businesses, and I think it's because of some of the work that you do at the Hispanic Chamber. Ruby, I know you are very busy and in high demand, so thank you for making time for us today.
Well, thank you so much.
All right, thank you guys. Right now, the Chamber is looking for interns. You have to be a student at West Texas A&M University, but they have plenty of opportunities if you want to get involved. To see this and our other women's suffrage stories, head to myhighplains.com. They're all under the community tab titled Women's History.